In this video, we will study the continuation of the gravitation. Let's focus on the weight and the gravitational potential energy. And this gravitational potential energy is, we will derive the general expressions of the finding the gravitational potential energy. So let's start with weight. When we say weight, weight is the quantity representing by a force exerted by a particle or object by an acceleration field, particularly the gravitational field of the Earth. Suppose we consider the Earth, whose mass is Me, the mass of Me, and the radius of Re. This is the radius of the Earth. Now, take note that the radius of the Earth is 6.37 times 10 raised to 6 meters. This was already identified. Now, suppose you are asked, how much is the weight of the person at the surface of the Earth, given the mass M? So what will you do? Okay. Now take note that if we apply the law of conservation of energy, Earth exerts a force on the man. So we have this FEM, means the force that Earth exerts on the man. Now, similarly, because the two particles interact, the man interacts with the Earth, then the man also exert a force on the Earth, representing F sub ME. Now, these two forces are equal. Take note, in our previous video, the force that the Earth exerts on man is the same as the force that man exerts on Earth. Whatever force applied to the Earth will be the force applied by the man also to the Earth. So take note that these values are the same. So therefore, we can say this is the force of gravity, or let us say big letter F as the force of gravity. Now take note that the distance between the Earth and the center to center distance of the Earth and the man is just the same as the radius of the Earth, because the height is not significant compared to the radius of the Earth. So let's say that the distance of the Earth and the man is the radius of the Earth. Now take note, the activity is located at the surface of the Earth. So therefore, calculating the, take note, this is gravitational force. The force that Earth exerts on man, or the force that man exerts on A, is the gravitational force. We will apply the law of conservation of, law of universal gravitation by Sir Isaac Newton. So applying the force of gravity now is the constant, the gravitational constant, multiplied by the product of the mass of the Earth, this is the mass of the Earth, by the mass of the man, divided by the center to center distance between the two particles, representing Re, square it. This is now following the law of universal gravitation. Okay, now take note that the gravitational force is the weight. So therefore, we can say that the weight of the man, which is the force of gravity, or the force that the Earth exerts to the man, is just equal to the gravitational acceleration, or gravitational constant, multiplied by the product of the mass of the Earth and the mass of the man, divided by the center-to-center distance between these two particles squared, or the radius of the Earth. Okay? Now remember that we define weight as the mass times the Earth's gravitational acceleration. So we can replace this with mass times the acceleration. By the way, remember, this is now the another formula for the weight, which is the gravitational constant times the product of the Earth, mass of the Earth, and the mass of the man, divided by the radius of the Earth square, which is served as the center to the center distance of the particle. Okay, now let's continue again that the weight is, we previously known that weight is mass times gravity, and it is true. Okay, the product of the mass and gravity is also weight. So equating the two, we have the mass times gravity is equal to the gravitational constant, big letter G, multiplied by the mass of the Earth times the mass of the man, divided by the square of the radius. So we can notice that this mass can be cancelled out. So we have the Earth's gravitational acceleration is equal to the gravitational constant, which is universal, multiplied by the mass of the Earth divided by the square of the radius of the Earth. Which means that if you want to calculate the Earth's gravitational acceleration, then you should have the mass of Earth and the radius, then use this formula, then you are calculating the Earth's gravitational acceleration. Okay? Now, take note that we know already how much is the Earth's gravitational acceleration. This is 9.81. So, in that value, we can now calculate the amount of the mass of the Earth. Okay? So, therefore, take note that we cannot measure the mass of the Earth. Instead, we will use a theoretical idea, and this is the theoretical idea to calculate for the mass of the Earth. So, transforming this equation becomes mass of the Earth is equal to the Earth's gravitational acceleration times the square of the radius of the Earth divided by the universal constant, the gravitational constant, which is universal true to all. Okay, so therefore, if we are to calculate how much is the mass of the Earth, we need the radius of the Earth. Okay, take note, the radius of the Earth is 6.37 times 10 raised to 6 meters. So MA means the mass of the Earth, RA means the radius of the Earth, where G is, take note, this is gravitational constant. And this is universal. This is 6.67 times 10 raised to negative 11 newton meter square per kilogram square. And G, small letter G, means the Earth's gravitational acceleration, which is a unit of a value of 9.81 times 10 raised to second square. So substituting all these values here, and we are calculating the mass of the Earth. Let's do it. So therefore, the mass of the Earth now becomes the 9.81 times 10 raised to 9.81 meter per second squared multiplied by the, take note, the radius of the Earth square, which is 6.37 times 10 raised to 6 square, divided by the gravitational constant, which is 6.67 times 10 raised to negative 11. The unit is newton meter square per kilogram square. By the way, this will be canceled. This is already 9.81, so you can cancel this one. The Earth's gravitational acceleration is equal to 9.81. So multiply it here, then divide, square it, the radius, then divide it by the gravitational constant. Then calculate, and the answer is the mass of the Earth is 5.97 times 10 raised to 24 kilograms. This is the mass of the Earth. Okay? Now, if you wish to calculate the mass of the Moon, you can utilize this formula, but you have to replace G with the Moon's gravitational acceleration and use the radius of the Earth. Then square it, divided by the same gravitational constant. So, this is true to all planets. You wish to calculate the mass of the Mars, then use the acceleration of gravity of the Mars, then you should have the radius of the Mars then divided by the same value. So this is true to all object. Okay, so again, the mass of the Earth, for now we have 9.97 times 10 raised to 24 kilogram. So we are able to obtain the data for the mass of the Earth by the use of the law of universal gravitation principle and applying the weight in terms of the gravitational constant, and we come up with this formula. Okay, so take note that the weight formula in terms of gravitational constant is equal to G, big letter G, which is the gravitational constant, multiplied by the mass of the Earth. This is the mass of the Earth, remember? Then we have the weight of any particle. This is if you wish to calculate the mass of the man, then use the weight of the man or mass of the man or any particle at the surface. Take note, this weight is at the surface of the earth only. If you are very far away from the surface, this force, this formula cannot be used. This is only with the region, okay, or the location wherein the particle is near the surface of the earth. Approximately, in that level, the acceleration is 9.81. If it is beyond, then this formula cannot be used. Okay, so take note of this formula. Okay, suppose you are now to calculate how much is the weight of this man and the mass is 60 kilograms. So suppose the mass is 60 kilograms. How much is the weight of the man? So we will use this formula. So the formula is the weight is equal to the gravitational constant. The mass of the earth, take note, is 5.97 times 10 raised to 20 per kilogram. And the mass of the man is 60 kilogram. Now, the radius of the earth will serve as the center-to-center distance, which is equivalent to 6.37 times 10 raised to 6 meters squared. Then, calculate, and you will be calculating the weight of this man, whose mass is 60 kilograms. Can you do it? So, calculate the weight of the man. All you need to do is to use this formula again. The acceleration, or the gravitational constant, the mass of the earth times the mass of the man, and the radius of the earth square, then do it. And this is 6.67 times 10 raised to 11 as the gravitational constant multiplied by the mass of the earth, which is 5.97 times 10 raised to 24 kilograms times the mass of the man, which is 60 kilograms, all over the radius of the earth, which is equal to 6.67 times 10 raised to 6 meter squared. Okay, so then use your calculator. Take note that the unit now become consistent. And this will be automatically what? This is a Newton unit. Why? Take note of the unit of the acceleration due to gravity. This is force, remember. This is force. So therefore, this is the force of gravity can use the law of universal gravitation. So then, calculate. And the answer is 589 Newtons. So therefore, we can say, if you are asked, how much is the weight of the man with mass of 60 kilograms? And the answer is 589 Newtons. This is in terms of the gravitational constant. But take note, previously, when we say weight, it is just the product of the mass times acceleration. Remember this formula? We used this in our previous videos. So, weight, take note, is the mass times gravity, where the gravity is the gravity of the earth because you are on the position at the surface of the earth. So, therefore, this is the weight of the man, which is, take note, the weight of the man is the force that the earth exerts on that man. That's why we formulate this formula in terms of the gravitational acceleration. So therefore, if this is the weight of the man, which is the mass times gravity, so if we substitute the mass of the man here, which is 60 kilograms, by 9.8, it should be 589 newtons also. So do it. Multiply 60 kilograms by 9.81, multiply it. The answer is 589 newtons. Derived the same answer. Okay, so therefore we can use any of these two, the weight in terms of the gravitational constant or the weight in terms of the gravitational acceleration. Small letter g is the gravitational acceleration, while the big letter g is the gravitational constant. They are not equal. Okay, so take note, small letter g is the earth's gravitational acceleration, while the big letter g is the gravitational constant. So, okay, this answers to the question. Now, let's proceed to the gravitational potential energy U. This is not new to us because we have this one video for the gravitational potential energy, and we assign that as U. But this time, we will provide a formula for the gravitational potential energy. This is the general expressions, which means that we will provide now the formula which is more general compared to previous. Okay, now why general? Because we can apply this to planet to planet problem. Okay, so what is that formula? So let's start with the Earth, and the Earth has a particle on top of it. Let's say the man. Okay, then the suppose the distance of the man from the center of the Earth is, let us see, R1. Or this is the initial position of the man. Now, in the final position, we have R2. So therefore, the man was displaced from R1 to R2. Position 1 and position 2. And our reference is always the center of the Earth. Okay, the question now is, how much is work done by this man? So how will you answer? So therefore, talking about work done, recall our previous video, the work done by force. Work done by force is the integral from R1 to R2, which is the initial position to the final position of the force dot dr, infinitesimal. That's why we have the integral sign. Now take note that our force now, by the way, what's that, the product, that product means? It is cosine. So we have F is cosine, dr, they are all in magnitude. So we remove, this is, by the way, this is vector. This is vector. Okay. Now, take note that the particle displaced from R1 to R2. So therefore, at any point of the travel from 1 to 2, the position is R without subscript. So that's why we have this as dr. dr is the infinitesimal displacement. Take note, this is directed outward from the radius of the Earth. This is outward from the radius of the Earth. Okay? So, therefore, we will substitute. By the way, if this is outward, and our force is downward, take note, the force of gravity is always inward. Our radius is outward. So, therefore, the force and the directions are in opposite direction. So therefore, this theta must be 180 degrees. So with that, our force is negative. So therefore, this is now the result. Take note that force is the force of gravity. So we will replace this force with the gravitational constant times the interacting masses. The interacting masses are the mass of the Earth and the mass of the man divided by the radius of the Earth, or the radius, or the position of the man at any point from 1 to 2. From 1 to 2 is from initial towards the final. Okay? So our limit is from R1 to R2. This is the initial position and this is the final position. Negative means what? Our force is inward while our displacement is outward. So therefore, our force must be a negative. Okay, so then evaluate the integral. Okay, by the way, these are constants, so we can put it outside the integral sign. So we leave up, by the way, including negative sign. So therefore, we have the integral of R1 to R2, 1 over R squared dr. So evaluate the integral. Take note, this is the same as negative 2. Okay, transferring this one from negative denominator to numerator. So we have to change the sign of the exponent. And we have this negative. So we can apply the power rule. So you have to add 1, then divide it the same. So negative 2 plus 1. So negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. So therefore, the integral of this is r raised to negative 1. And take note, it is a negative number. Okay? By the way, we have the discrepancy. This is negative. This is negative. Okay? So, therefore, evaluate the integral. And the answer is this one. Okay? Okay. Now, take note, this is negative also. We have another. Okay? This is negative. Because take note that the integral of this is negative 2 plus 1. So the answer is negative 1. So bring it down. So we have r. But we have to divide this by negative 1. So therefore, this must be a negative answer. Okay, then continue. So therefore, this must be what? This must be negative, okay? This is negative. This is R2, okay? This is applying the upper limit. This is R2 minus R1, okay? Upper substitute here, then lower, this should be R1. This should be R1, okay? And this is negative. And this minus, okay? So we have positive. Okay, then substitute, then we have this result, okay? Then take note, this is negative change in potential energy. By the way, this is negative and this is negative. Okay, negative, and this is negative become plus, so outside, so this must be positive. Okay, or the work, take note, the work done is change in potential energy. Okay, so therefore, by the way, you take note this one, this negative means this is the this should be U2, and this should be U1, or this is by the definition of the gravitational potential energy in terms of the gravitational constant. So therefore, this term, which is negative GMAM over R2, will be our initial potential energy subtracted by the initial gravitational potential energy. This is U1. So take note that this should be negative. That's why this is negative. So if we substitute, if this is R2, so this must be U2. So therefore, this negative now becomes U2. That's why we have this U2. And this one, this is, if this is R1, so this should be U1. So this negative GMAM over R1 should be our U1. In such that, we are consistently says that work done by potential is always a negative change in potential energy. Okay? Or the work done by gravitational potential energy is just a negative change in gravitational potential energy. Change means final minus initial. So therefore, for now, this is the definition of the gravitational potential energy in terms of the gravitational constant. Okay, so take note, mass ma is the mass of Earth, re is the radius of the Earth, where r, take note, this is the distance of the object from the center of the Earth. So it should be coming from the center always of the Earth. If you use this formula, always remember that r is from the center of the Earth. And remember, the radius of the Earth is 6.37 times 10 raised to 6 meters. So therefore, we can always add that radius if the activity is above the surface of the Earth. You have always to add the radius of the Earth, because take note, R is the distance of the object from the center of the Earth. And Z, again, is 6.67 times 10 raised to negative 11 Newton meter square per kilogram square. Okay, so this formula, again, this is the general expression of gravitational potential energy. This is what we are looking for. This is the formula that we need to use if we are calculating the gravitational potential energy in terms of the gravitational constant. Okay, so let us apply this formula. How to apply this formula to the actual problem or problem in everyday life? Okay, let's solve another problem. This is problem number 2. Take note that the gravitational potential energy is negative gravitational constant times the mass of the Earth times the mass of the man or particle divided by R. But take note, this R is the center, is the distance from the center of the Earth towards the location of this particle whose mass is m. And this negative means this is an outward, because force is always towards the radial, but our R is outward from the radius of the Earth. So okay, so then now remember that the mass of the Earth is 985.97 times 10 raised to 24, while the radius is 6.37 times 10 raised to 6. We need this value, so you have to bear in mind about these values if we are talking about the activity on the Earth. Now the problem now says that we have the three men and they want to went to the moon, okay, by means of a shield. So they will riding on the shield, and this shield was with the three men inside will be ejected using the cannon, giant cannon sunk. So this representing giant cannon sunk. Then we have this shield, this blue color ellipsoid, and inside the shield are the three men ready to win to move in the moon. Okay, but before that we have this testing activity. So the question now is, by the way, they will fire this shield will be fired from the surface of the Earth using this cannon. So therefore there must be a velocity or the speed requirement. Problem says that find the minimum speed or muscle speed needed to shoot the shield straight up at the height of above the Earth equal to the radius of the Earth. So therefore first activity in the problem letter A, we want to know how much is the velocity be applied at the surface of the Earth in such that this shield will moves up or away from the surface of the Earth, which is equivalent to the radius of the Earth. So therefore in that case this shield must stop at a certain distance, and take note that distance is the radius of the Earth, wherein beyond that approximately the acceleration now will keep on changing. It is no longer 9.81. So for this problem, the radius of the Earth, so we have to eject this, then it stop at a certain point. So the dynamics now is moving from initial point towards the final point 2. Now what is the speed if we have this radius the same as the radius of the Earth from the surface of the Earth? So we have this requirement, how much is the minimum muscle speed? Now remember that this is the speed at the initial point 1, and in the final point 2 this must be 0. Okay, it will stop at this point. So then to answer this one is, take note, this is purely dynamics of motion. Now since the dynamic of motion, then we can apply the conservation of energy. Energy is conserved. And remember that conservation of energy is universal. It can be applied anywhere, not only at the surface of the Earth. So therefore, it works that the initial energy must be equal to the final energy. So apply this principle. So take note that when we see E1 is the total energy initial. So we have the total energy initial mechanical, we have the kinetic energy and the gravitational potential energy. While E2 is the same, we have the kinetic energy final and we have the potential energy final, gravitational potential energy final. So therefore we have this E1 as the kinetic energy initial at point 1, and this is the gravitational potential at point 1 at the surface of the Earth. It should be equated by the sum of the two, the kinetic energy final and the potential energy final. Remember that K2 will be 0. Why that K2 is 0? This is 0 because at point 2 the object will stop, so the velocity is 0. Now remember, kinetic energy is a function of velocity. If this is 0, kinetic energy is also 0. So therefore, this must be 0. Now substituting the K, remember kinetic energy is 1/2 mv². So it should be 1/2 mv². The mass of the shield with the three men inside multiplied by the square of velocity, which is unknown. unknown. Okay, so leave it as unknown. Then, the initial potential energy at the surface of the Earth, take note of this formula. This is negative. This is negative. So this is gravitational constant times the mass of the Earth times the mass of the Moon divided by the radius of the Earth. This is by definition. Take note of this R. Remember, this R formula is the distance from the center of the Earth. So it should be measured. This R should be starting from this point towards this point. So therefore, this should be Re also. Now, this should be equal to zero. The kinetic energy is zero. And this one is U2. The U2 now is what? Using this formula, the same mass of the Earth, the same mass of the moving particle, but it differs with R. Our R now is 2 times the radius. Because the question says that what will be the minimum speed or that speed at that point wherein the displacement is the same as the radius of the Earth. So therefore, this should be twice the radius of the Earth. Okay? So then, take note of this. These are like terms. These are like terms because they have the same constant. We have the mass of the Earth, mass, the particle, and it differs only with, because this is Re and this is Re, it differs only with the denominator of 2. So this is considered as one whole, while this one is one half. If you transpose this one to the other side, becomes plus, so this should be positive 1. While this one is a negative 1 half. So what is 1 minus 1 half? It is 1 half. Okay? By the way, before that, this mass will be cancelled out. Remember, if you notice in the problem, there is no given. No given for the mass. Which means that if you are talking with velocity, regardless of what mass is that, mass can be ignored. Okay, any particle will provide the same velocity, any masses. Okay, so then go back to the problem. So ignore minus the R, M, because M will be cancelled out. Still, this one R like terms. When you transpose this one, becomes 1, and this is 1 half. So 1 minus 1 half is 1 half. So therefore, we will come up with a result with 1 half B square, because mass was cancelled, equals, because this will be transposed, this is 1 minus 1 half, so therefore, the result is 1 half of the gravitational acceleration constant times the mass of the Earth divided by the radius of the Earth. Okay, so there should be 1 half. This 1 half is the result after combining these two. Okay, so then we will cancel this 1 half also, because we have the 1 half and we have the 1 half. Then take square root both sides, so therefore this will be the answer. This is the velocity. If you want to move from the surface of the Earth, you want to move the same at a distance which is equivalent to the radius of the Earth, equivalent to the radius of the Earth, then use this velocity. You need to multiply the requirements is only, by the way, because this is constant and this is serve as constant because it's the mass of the Earth, and take note, this is the radius of the Earth. So therefore, if you want to have it, the final position with the radius of the Earth equivalent to the radius Re, which is the radius of the Earth from the surface, then you have to evaluate this one. So use the values, the 6.67 times 10 to the 11, 5.27 times 10 to the 24 as the mass of the Earth divided by the radius 6.37 times 10 to the 6. Evaluate this one and you will be providing 7,910 meters per second. This is the minimum muscle speed in order to move the shell straight up with the displacement equivalent to the radius of the Earth. Which means that below this number, you cannot stop at that point. Okay? So therefore, this will be the minimum. Above this value, then it will move in a far away distance wherein maybe there is no particle that interact with this particle, so therefore it was in the vacuum. Okay, so then it will stay in that part. So therefore the velocity is 7,910 meter per seconds. Okay, so then look at number 2, letter B. Number 2, same question, find the minimum muscle speed. But this time, that would allow the shield to escape from the Earth completely, which means this velocity is not the escape velocity, which means that you will be, from this point, you will be returning back to the Earth. Why? Because this is not the escape velocity. Greater than this, or be specific, how much is that escape velocity? This will be our problem number two. Which means, if you want to eject something, if you want to eject something from the surface of the Earth and you don't want to return it back to the Earth, then you have to introduce a velocity which is equivalent to the escape velocity. The question now is, how much is the escape velocity? It depends on the mass of the object? The answer is no. Look at this problem. Remember this problem number A. When you are solving velocity, it does not need the mass of that moving particle. But look at this one. This will be cancelled. Okay? So therefore, the escape velocity also will do. There is no requirement of mass as long as you will be providing that velocity to that object. Okay, so therefore, if you are projecting greater mass, then you need to introduce greater force in order to eject that object with the velocity requirement, the escape velocity. Now the question now is how much is the escape velocity? That will be the problem. By the way, this is to remind that for simplicity, we ignore the air resistance, we ignore the rotation of the Earth, because the rotation of the Earth will affect the motion of the particle. And the gravitational pull of the moon. Remember, we are close to the moon. So the moon, because of its mass, it has the ability to attract particle. But this time, because it is far away distance compared to the Earth, then we can ignore the effect of that. So let's us consider focusly on the factors involving Earth's activity. Only it is the gravitational pulls only. Okay, so therefore, to answer this problem is quite similar. The process still dynamics. Okay, the formula to be used is the conservation of energy. Still, we can apply the conservation of energy because again, conservation of energy is universal. It can be applied not only at the surface of the Earth. Okay, it can be anywhere. So therefore, our starting point. Okay, by the way, you need to eject this shield. So this must be of a greater speed, instead that it won't return to the surface of the Earth. So we call that as the escape velocity. So how much is the escape velocity? So you have to eject. Then it will not return back anymore. It moves in a very far distance from the surface of the Earth, which means that this R is going to an infinite number. Okay, so again, use the conservation of energy. The energy initial is equal to the energy final. The final is in a very far away place from the surface of the Earth. So then again, we have still the mechanical energies, the kinetic and the gravitational potential energy initial and the finals. So then look at this one. Take note, in a far away distance, the kinetic energy is zero. Okay, because the velocity is keep on reducing until it reaches to zero. Aside from that, this one is also zero. The gravitational potential energy in the far away distance is zero. Why? Because look at this formula. This formula is inversely proportional to the radius or the distance from the center of the Earth, which means that the greater the R, the smaller the value of the potential. This is inversely proportional. So therefore, if this is in a far away distance, which means that this R is an infinite number, so then this will become zero. So therefore, U2 must be zero in a far away distance. So therefore, we can equate this to zero in the right side. So we have now only the kinetic energy, which is 1/2 mv², and this is energy at the surface of the Earth. We have the negative following the formula, and this is mass A times the mass of the particle, and we have the radius of the Earth. Again, mass will be cancelled out. Remember, this means to say that regardless of what mass is that, as long as you are able to eject that object with the velocity requirement. So in this case, we are on the way to calculate the escape velocity. So transpose this to the right side, what will happen? This will become plus. Okay, so this is gma over re, and this is 1/2. So solving for b, diagonal product 2 becomes on the numerator, then take square root. So we come up with the velocity, escape velocity, is equivalent to the square root of 2 gma over r. So this is the, by the way, this is again transpose. Okay, then by the way, this is again, here you are, this should be not a square. So this is gma over re. So then after that, next is what? Diagonal product, then take square root. So we come up with this result, the square root of 2 gma over r. This is the escape velocity requirement. You want to eject something, you have to provide this velocity. This is the minimum velocity. So the if you substitute the values of gma and re, so we have this result. Then calculate, okay, this is the escape velocity. The velocity, which is the escape velocity, is 1.12 times 10 raised to 4 meter per second. So therefore, we can say that if you eject something and your velocity is 1.12 times 10 raised to 4 meter per second, that object will not return, will not go back to the Earth surface. No returning back to that. And this is the, because this escape velocity. This velocity 1.12 times 10 to 4 or more will allow the particle to move out from the Earth gravitational field anymore. It will not return back. But below this number, there is a big possibility that that particle will move going back to the Earth. Okay? So again, if you want to move something, and you want to move, okay, be sure to have this velocity. So for example, because this trimming will move towards the moon, so therefore you have to aim your cannon towards the direction of the moon, then be sure to have this, meet this requirement, escape velocity. It should be greater than this value, because if this is exactly the velocity of that particle of the ejection, then it will, take note, it will stop at that point because the velocity is zero. Okay, now it should be greater than this so that you will be moving directly towards the moon. So you are now moving towards the moon with a constant speed. Okay, now be sure to have that speed, because after, you are decelerating from the surface of the Earth, decelerating until such time that the velocity at that point is zero. So you will stop at that point. So if you want to move towards the moon, it should be greater than this number. Okay, so then it will move now at a constant speed without changing its magnitude until such time that once you are now in the gravitational field of the moon, then you will be attracted. Then after, during the time, then you are now on the area of the field area of the moon. Okay, that's the process of moving from Earth to moon. You have to meet the escape requirement, the escape velocity, and this is the escape velocity. Now be sure to aim that target straight to the moon, because if it is not in the region directed towards the region of the gravitational field of the moon, then you will be moving to another planet. Okay, so this answers to the questions. So kindly solve this one. This is practice problem number one and practice problem number two. Try to solve this one. Go back to our discussion. Then if you have something to recall or to verify, then do that, solve this one. This is a very nice problem. Okay, so that's all. Thank you. See you in my next video.